Not too long ago, I talked with Dale Bohannon, whom I've known since, I guess, the mid-1980s. And he told me something very interesting that he found back in the fall of 2000 while he was on a business trip. Listen to this, folks.
I was pulled to the side road, which was a new cut gravel dirt road in front of a business, a builder supply business, actually Top Notch Builder Supply in Madison, Georgia. To my right, this was previously was a soybean field, and this little new cut road divided this field. And the right side of the road was filled with, which I thought was portable toilets. I never looked at them that close. Same in color, maybe black, but which was an odd color. And I was sitting there going over my notes, and a van pulled alongside of me that turned out to be the property owner. And he greeted me, and he was by himself, and so we had a good little dialogue there, and I asked him about the field of black boxes. What were they? Because I'd never seen anything like that. And his statement was that if he told me, I would be one of few people in Madison, Georgia that knew about them. And he says they're disposable coffins, I believe he told me. And he says there's 100, at that time, he said there was 125,000 there. And they were stacked, he told me, 15 high. I asked him who owned them, and he stated that the CDC owned them and that they were leasing the land, leasing his land for storage. And he said his brother worked with the CDC in Atlanta and had been asked by the CDC to do a 3-year extension to place temporary morgues all across the nation.
So in January of this year, 2005, we decided to drive to beautiful Madison, Georgia and take a look for ourselves. It was on a Sunday and no one was around, with the exception of this one pickup truck that was coming out the narrow road that we were going in on next to this field. We flagged down the pickup truck, and it was providential that the driver of this pickup truck turned out to be the son of the man that owned this field. So naturally, we started asking him questions. And he told us that not long ago, there had been as many as 500,000 of these grave liners or disposable coffins. We asked him for permission if we could look around, and he said yes, so we did.
We're just getting an idea for the size of these boxes. What could these boxes be used for? Well, they're called casket liners. And that's an interesting term, isn't it? It's a casket liner. When I first heard the term casket liner, I thought perhaps a lining for a casket. But this is too big to be on the inside of a casket. So certainly this could be used as a casket. This is an inexpensive casket. And you can see the size here. There's lots of room. I think my friends here, we could all probably get inside. It might be a little cozy, but we'd fit just fine. Which tells me that these liners can be used for more than just one. And one more time, what kind of liners are these?
Casket liners.
These are casket liners.
That's what the man said.
That's what the man told us. And we're told that there are about, well, there were about 500,000 out here.
Later, as I went back to my home office, I spoke of it there, and of course people usually don't want to hear too much about this kind of thing, so it's never been mentioned publicly except just here and there. because most, like I said, the reaction I got, people didn't want to know about it, the few people that I spoke to, and so I just dropped it. And until I went to a luncheon, a fundraiser for Representative Saxby Chambliss. He was running for his second term for the U.S. House of Representatives. And it was a crowd, probably 100, maybe 150. It was congressmen, senators, state senators, and mayors. There was one table we probably had 2-3-star generals and a couple of 1-star with their spouses. So it was a real high-powered meeting. But the keynote speaker was a congressman, and I don't remember his name. He'd just been in the House for a long time, and he was the chairman of the Armed Services Committee. And so he just spoke in behalf of Representative Chambliss and the importance of having him on board to be reelected due to our threats. But it had to do with the nuclear devices that was missing from the old Soviet Union, and they had gotten into terrorist hands. And it was, the emphasis was on the critical state that we face in this country. And he said we could lose tens of millions of people in the next decade, and he used those terms, due to a nuclear strike on U.S. soil. And I was sitting there, and it became very clear to me that that could very well explain why just weeks, I mean, could be 2 to 3 weeks prior to that meeting, that I had stumbled upon these, at that time, 125,000 disposable liners or caskets or coffins or whatever that could be termed as in that soybean field in Madison, Georgia.
Did you catch what he said, friends? At this high-powered meeting, it was in Perry, Georgia, near Robins Air Force Base, the largest employer in the state of Georgia, Robins Air Force Base. The chairman of the Armed Services Committee was the keynote speaker. The chairman of the Armed Services Committee, whoever that may be, used to be Sam Nunn of Georgia, from the district I was born and raised in. Whoever that chairman is generally one of the most powerful men in Washington. And I can't remember the chairman's name at that time myself, but he said, this was in the year 2000, I believe, that in the next 10 years, possibly due to nuclear strikes, tens of millions of people could lose their lives. And we've just read what our prophet said. Now, what we've just seen is one United States city outside, this is Atlanta, it has a metropolitan population area of roughly 4 million people. So this is one field outside of one U.S. city, and the brother of the man that owns this field, that the government is leasing this field from to store these disposable coffins, this brother was given 3 years to set up temporary morgues around the country. Now, we found the website that we think these disposable coffins were made at, and we noticed that the lids that they're advertising on the website were rounded. But the lids, hundreds of thousands of lids there, the lids we found, folks, were flat, and they were reinforced. You know what that could mean? You can stack them on top of each other. That's a lot neater to stack them in disposable coffins than what we saw after the tsunami, when we would see bulldozers digging holes and taking bodies and pushing bodies into holes. America can stomach this much better.